certified fitness instructor at the Southgate Center here in Woodstock. Now, what we're going to do today is a fitness class entirely in a chair. The class is going to consist of a warm-up, then I'm going to go directly into a 10-minute cardio. After that, we'll cool down, then we'll go into some balance, working the muscles from the hip down, remaining in the chair. After the balance, we're going to do some strengthening. Now, the equipment that I'm going to use today is a ball. If you don't have a ball, an alternative, just grab a pillow. I have a pillow that's a little bit longer. I could fold it in half if I was using it, and I could use that. After the strengthening, we'll go directly into the stretches. So let's get started, and I'll ask for my music to get turned on. I'm sitting up nice and straight. I want you to bum walk to the back of the chair. When you're at the back of the chair, I don't want you leaning on the back. I want you sitting up, supporting your back. Warm up. Just ear to shoulder. Warm-ups are so important at the beginning. And do chin to chest. Quite often you go to sport events and you see people doing stretches right at the beginning before they do their event. Put your hands to the side. I don't know. But stretches should actually be done after the event. You don't want to stretch cold muscles. Shoulder roll to the back. Warming up the upper back and the shoulders and to the front. And hand to ceiling, reach up. And other hand. Do that again. Other. And other. So we're just doing warm up of the upper body. Put your arms in a W. Elbow kisses. Now when my elbows go back, shoulder blades together, warming up that upper back. Sing along if you want. Arms wide, starting at the waist, all the way up to the chest. Back down to the waist. Scissors to the back. Bend those elbows. The easiest part of the whole class. Twirl those wrists. And the other way. Stretch those fingers. Cat claw. Crunch them up. Now bum walk to the front of the chair. We warmed up the upper part of the body. Let's warm up the lower part. Posture, chin back, pull your belly tight. So we're warming up the hips. Tiptoe. Toes to the ceiling, warming up those shins, ankles. I don't have any shoes on, I just want to for you to really see what I'm doing with my feet. Now put your feet together and toes out. Put your feet together and heels out. Put your feet together and tiptoe. Focus on that posture. Toes to the ceiling. Put your left toe forward. Lift the knee and forward. toe forward. Warming up the feet, or not the feet, but the hips. Upper legs. Put your left foot to the side. Put your other foot to the side. Let's go for a bit of a swim. You'll notice a lot of my moves for the seated class, very similar to the standing class. Are you ready for cardio? Posture, ribs, chin. Now during the class, if you find you're getting fatigued in the hip, just put your heels up. Your choice. Or do that through the whole cardio. Wide march. Heel dig. 3, 2, 1. No such number. Arms if you want. We had a quarrel. High knees. 3, 2, 1. Half circle with those arms. Remember, sing. Three more big, wide half circles. One more. High knees. Remember, could be just heel dig or heel lifts. Side tap, left leg. 3, 2, 1. This time I'm gonna take advice. Arms if you want. Belly always forward. If it comes back the very next day, then I'll understand. Riding on it. Return to sender. 3, 2, high knees. No such number. W. Clean those big truck windows. Opposite direction. One more. High knees. Back tap. 3, 2, 1. Arms if you want. Now you have a choice. You can do just arms. We're going to do some laundry from your right up to your left. 3, 2, 1. No twisting. Reach for the ceiling if you can. Reach. I always say no twisting because I don't want hurting backs. Alternating knee lifts. 3, 2, 1. Three, two, one. forget we're 16. We're dancing. We're going to pick up some heavy weight. 2 or 3 pounds. And do some boxing. 3, 2, 1. Reach for that bag. And I don't mean the old bag sitting in front of you here. Forehead. Uppercut. Keep those weights in your hands. Feel those muscles in the bicep. Round robin. Bellies forward. Range of motion both shoulders. Plus strengthening. 3, 2, 1. Knees high or heels. Hands at your hip. Your left foot side tap. 3, 2, 1. Now I'm going to ask you to put your foot forward in a second, or stay side. Just get those arms working. Foot forward. Keep in mind, the arms are your choice. Foot back. Really feeling it in that left hip. Side. Flip to the other side. 3, 2, flip. Foot forward. I always feel so good when we flip. On range of motion of the knee. Side. Knee, lift, 3, 2, 1. Next thing we're going to do is a bit of a run. For a slow count of 10. 3, 2, 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Hope everybody's feeling good. Now, if you find, because it may be your first class after a while, if you're just exhausted, you can't go any further, just do the heel lifts. Last song. We're going to put hands forward twice, ceiling twice, side twice. 3, 2, 1. So the cardio is only 10 minutes. Maybe later on when I do further classes, we might increase it to 15. Last one. Get your elbows at your waist. Pick up those heavy weights. Heel dig. 3, 2, 1. Lift. Heavy weights. Roll last thump. Hands forward. Hands to the ceiling if you can. Let's hug a tree. Shoulder blades together. Let's hug a cloud if you can. tap. 3, 2, 1. Because you've been doing cardio for a few minutes, your hips should be a little bit looser. Back tap. 3, 2, 1. Push that door. Alternating knee lifts. 3, 2, 1. We are done. Now we need to cool down. During the cardio, I had your wrist often above your head or above your shoulders. That's what gets that heart beating. Swim forward. Now during the cool down, I'm going to make sure your wrists are below your heart. Swim backwards. The reason is I'm trying to slow your heart down. Put the blood back into the big muscles. Twirl those wrists. Stretch those hands. Cat claw. Bunch them up. I don't know with those shoulders. Shoulder roll to the back. And to the front. Chin to chest. Shoulder and other ear. Okay, so I'm hoping now the heart has slowed down, because the next thing that I want to do is balance. We will remain in the chair, and I'm just going to work on strengthening the muscles from the hips down. So what I want you to do is put your feet a little bit apart, perfect posture, of course. And what I'm going to ask you to do, we'll start with your left leg, and I want you to push down on that floor just with your left leg as if you're trying to lower that floor. So push, push, push. Your other leg is relaxed. And relax. Let's do the other leg. Push. When you're pushing, you're working on hips. Upper leg, you're working on lower leg and your ankle. And relax. Three more on each side. Other side, push. Now, let's say if you used a wheelchair, you still want to maintain the muscles and relax. Other leg. In the lower part of your body, because you still need muscles. Let's say if you went from the chair to your bed. And relax. Two more times each side. Push. And push. Other people that may want to do a sit down are people that either use a walker, or let's say they just, and one more time each side. Push the other one. Push, 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 push. If you have any balance issues, you may want to do a sit-down class. And the last one, push. Great. Now the next thing I want you to do, straight posture, just with your left knee, just lift it for the count of 4, 3, 2, 1, and bring it down. Three more times. Left knee. Holding it, feeling the strengthening in the hip, the upper leg, and bring it down. Two more times. Up. And down. One more time. Up. 4, 3, 2, 1, and down. Let's do the other side, same thing. Two more times. Up. Four. Three. Two. One. One more. Up. Four. Three. Two. One. And down. Last thing for balance, what I want to do is what I refer to as kicking the soccer ball, and I'll show you what it is. With your left leg, you're just going to bring it up to the side a little bit, and then you're going to side kick that soccer ball. Perfect posture. And left leg side, just a bit, and kick. When I say just a bit, it's not like a side leg raise, side. It's just, once again, range of motion of the hip, strengthening. We'll do six of these all together, so three more after this one. Same thing on the other side. So your right leg, just a bit to the side. Side kick. Simple, easy move, but when you've been doing it for a few times, by the time you get to be three or four, you'll feel the strengthening in that hip. Let's do three more. We're always looking for a little bit of burn, but not pain. Last one. Excellent. So that's going to be it for balance. You'll find as we're doing strength, I could do more balance, but during the strength, we're using a lot of the same muscles that I would use through the balance. Next thing I want to work on is your lower back. So you're going to sit up straight, put your feet hip-width apart. Always start with a straight posture. And what we're going to be doing is leaning forward. But before you do, just to let you know what I don't want to see you do. I don't want you leaning at the waist. Anytime during fitness that we lean forward, it's always, always, always at the hip. So lean forward. Now when I'm leaning forward, I'm keeping my eyes to the front. If I look down at the floor, all my neck muscles are relaxed. Once I look up, those neck muscles are getting strengthening. Now I'm going to try to go down a little farther. Exhale. Slowly bring it up. We'll do eight more of these. Down. So where I'm feeling it, go farther down if you can. I'm feeling it in the lower back and up. I also feel it when I go down. I can also feel it in my hips, and it goes right up almost to my shoulder blades and up and down. When strengthening, as far as the numbers, the repetition, we should do at least eight, but anywhere between 8 and 15 would be great. But because this class, we don't want it to go too long, I will stop at 8. Down, feeling lower back, and up. We'll do three more. Now put your arms in the W, posture straight, work the upper back, elbows back, shoulder blades together, feel those muscles working, and relax. Now if you want, put your hands in a fist, elbows back, just working more muscles, eight all together. Back, shoulders are down, don't crunch up the shoulders. And forward, and back. And forward, four more. Back, and forward, and back. Doing fitness exercises, such a great thing that you can do for your body. Two more. You're really doing yourself a favor. And forward. One more time. Elbow back. And forward. Give yourself a little bit of a shake and a loosening. Next thing I want you to do is to grab your ball or pillow, your choice. When you put a ball, I want you to put it between your legs, but I do not want you to put it between your knees at no time. Always put it a little closer to your body. So posture's nice and straight. Squeeze the ball to break it. And relax. Now squeeze the ball to break it again. Now turn your head to the left and hold it there for 4, 3, 2, 1, and relax. One more time. Squeeze the ball to break it. Turn your head to the left. Now further to the left. Look at that blind spot. 4, 3, 2, 1, and relax. Let's do the same thing on the other side. Squeeze the ball to break it. Posture straight. Turn your head to the right. 4, 3, 2, 1. And relax. One more time. Squeeze the ball to break it, feeling all the muscles in your upper leg, your hip. Turn your head to the right again. Further to the right. 4, 3, 2, 1. And relax. Pick your hand up with your left hand, put it on your left knee. Put your other hand on top. Keep the posture straight. And I want you to push down on that ball. What I don't want you to do is to lean forward and then push with your body. Keep the posture straight, pushing down using only shoulder and arm muscles. At the same time, lift that left foot. 4, 3, 2, 1, and relax. We're going to do three more on each. Push. 4, lift. 4, 3, 2, 1, and relax. Two more times. Push, lift, 4, 3, 2, 1, and relax. One more time. Let's push to break that ball. Lift, 4, 3, 2, 1. Great exercise. Shoulders, core, upper back, arms, right hand, right knee. Other hand on top. Push, lift, 4, 3, 2, 1, and relax. Push, lift, 4, 3, 2, 1, and relax. Two more times. Push, lift, 4, 3, 2, 1, and relax. One more time. Push to break that ball and lift. Keep in mind, if anything hurts, don't do it. It is your class. And relax. Perfect. Next thing I want you to do is work on the biceps. Put your left hand forward. Put the ball on the muscle of that arm. Fold it up so the heel of your hand is on that ball. And squeeze. 4, 3, 2, 1, and relax. Three more times. Squeeze. 4, 3, 2, 1. Two more times. Squeeze. 4, 3, 2, 1. One more time. Squeeze. 4, 3, 2, 1, and relax. Take the ball. Now put it under the upper part of your left arm, right above your elbow. Put your left hand, palm of your hand, to the ceiling. Now squeeze that elbow towards your body, keeping your shoulder down. Don't crunch anything up. And relax. Three more times. Squeeze. And what you're doing is you're working on the muscle right, not quite at the back, but between the front and the back of your arm. And relax. Two more times. Squeeze. Four. Three. Two. One. And relax. One more time. Let's break that ball. Four. Three. Two. One. Let's do the same thing on the other side. So put your right hand out and put the ball on the muscle of that arm. Fold it up so the palm of your hand, not the palm or the heel of your hand, is on that ball. And squeeze. And just hold it. Now, if you find that that hurts, don't do it. And relax. Squeeze. Any arthritis in the wrists might cause more pain than what you're used to. And relax. Two more times. We always say that when you come in and you do have arthritis, you're going to be in pain. And relax. One more time, break that ball. But after the class, let's say 10, 20 minutes after the class, if the pain level is way more than what you're used to, that's a sign you've done too much. Great. Okay, now the next thing I want you to do is to put the, we don't want you being a little lopsided. Put the ball under your right arm, just above your elbow. Put your hand to the ceiling and elbow to body. And holding it for the four. And relax. Three more times. Elbow to body. Now, always focus on breathing. Don't hold your breath through any of these classes. And relax. And elbow to body. And relax. One more. Let's break that ball. Four, three, two, one. And relax. Now, the next thing I want you to do is to work on your shins. And what I'll be having you do is just lift up those toes, and I'm going to have you do it for 30 seconds. So I'm just looking at my watch. I'll tell you when to start. And let's get started. So while I'm doing this, like right now, very easy when you first begin. Have a nice quick toes up. My posture's straight. My chin is tight. So throughout the class, I often talk about having your posture straight. Every time you do that, you're working the muscles in the back, even when you're sitting in a car. Lift up those ribs, straighten that body, and you'll actually find, 30 seconds is up. Great. You'll actually find that as time goes on, those muscles, when you're sitting up straight, you will build those muscles. Now, the last thing I want you to do for strengthening today is I want you to put your ball on your lap, put your lower arm around it. And what you're going to do is put your hands together. And now we're going to do some elbow kisses. So elbows together, four, three, two, one, and relax. Eight times all together, elbows. Four, three, two, one, relax. Elbow kiss. Four, three, two, one, and relax. Elbow kiss. Four, three, two, one, and relax. Let's do four more. Elbow kiss. Four, three, two, one. Two, let's break that ball. Elbow kiss. Four, three, two, one, and relax. One more time. Elbow kiss. Four, three, two, one, and relax. Excellent. So that's going to be it for strength. The last thing we have to do for the class is our stretches. As I said at the beginning, don't leave. The stretches are so important because if you're doing new strengthening or even the cardio, you may find you're a little stiff and the stretches may help with that. So what you're going to do is put your left foot forward, point that toe to the ceiling, left hand, right shoulder, other one underneath, and pull it over. Might as well pull that belly button nice and tight. Crunch up those fingers. Point that toe to the ceiling. So you're stretching your legs, you're stretching your upper back, your shoulder. Now put that left foot flat. You'll feel the stretch in your shin. Put your left hand on your left shoulder, elbow to the ceiling. Now keep in mind, if your elbow only goes that far, that's totally fine. This is your class. Now I'm going to push that elbow up to stretch the tricep, stretch the left side of the body. Hold the stretches for 15 seconds. And the next thing we're going to do is lift that left knee up, toe up and down. And twirl. And twirl the other way. Windshield. Now let's do the same thing on the other side. So right heel forward, toe pointing to the ceiling, right hand, left shoulder, the one underneath, pull it over. Flick those fingers. So focus on pointing that toe to the ceiling, stretching out the calves, really the entire leg and the foot. You're also stretching that shoulder, upper back. Now gently put that foot flat. Now feel the stretch in your shin. Put your right hand on your right shoulder and lift it up as far as you can. So we hold these for the 15 seconds. Hands together. Beach ball between your arms or between your elbows, shoulders are down. What you're focusing on here is stretching those shoulder blades apart. Through the whole class, we actually use the upper back and the shoulders. Right from the warm-up through to the strengthening. Now put your hands to the side. Now push those. Push the elbows back. Focus on the elbows. Your shoulders are down. What you're focusing on here is stretching those chest muscles. Of course, I'm sitting up straight, always pulling my belly tight. So we're going to get some oxygen into our lungs and we're going to inhale. Fill up those lungs. Now forcefully exhale. One more time. Inhale. And exhale. Wonderful. So today's class was an entire sitting down class. We covered warm up, we covered balance, and cardio, and strength, and stretches, all from a chair. So I really hope you enjoyed today's class. And what I want to do, as I always say, I couldn't survive in these classes without Guy, my techie. And so I want everybody to stay safe, stay fit, and stay healthy. Jump, jump, jump up.